Hello, everybody! It's birthday week! It's my birthday, and it's birthday fairy week for this fairy. Here, grab some more of this magic fairy glitter. Come for a boogie. I'm going to get my rainbow magical balloon maracas out. Are you ready, everybody? Let's do it! Don't blame it on the moonlight. Don't blame it on the good times. Blame it on the booger. Sunshine. Don't blame it on the moonlight. Don't blame it on the good times. Blame it on the booger. Woohoo! Let's turn this off for a second because you know what day it is. It is FriYay story time and so magical on my birthday week. And also happy birthday to all my fairy friends that I don't get to see for their birthday parties. So happy birthday to you all. And I wish that I was there. But hey, I'm here now. So joining on FriYay story time. And we are reading our special book, which is Some Days Are Mashed Potato. Now, if you can remember back only about 7 days ago when the magical Wibbly Wombles was in such a fairy pickle and Fairy Emma was flying through the sky in such a rush to get back to the Wibbly Wombles wizard with his magic pouch, the make everything right pouch. Luckily, she got there even when she had a leg hanging out of her ear, and she made it to the fairy tree hospital thanks to the munching hippopotamus's munchesses. And she gave Wizzy the magic pouch and had to remind him that his cauldron was inside his magical hat. Oh! And I had accidentally turned you all into upside down peculiar creatures with my magic fairy bubble wand. So I hope you guys turn back to normal. But let's get ready for our magic story. So let's open our books to page number 45 and let's start. Suddenly, an amazing bubble of truly magnificent magic swirled around Mrs. Diddle, a little bit like this magic dust. Should we do it again? It's my birthday, so we can do it again. Here we go. Woo! And it swirled and burled around her, Miss Diddle, Fairy Emma, and Stardust all at the same time. Wimbly Wombles clapped his hands 3 times. Do you want to clap your hands with me 3 times? Let's do it. 1, 2, 3. Well done. And pow, the pickly mix-up spells were undone just like that. Ah! So clever, that Wimbly Womble wizard, when he can get his fairy magical thinking hat on. Wow, said Mrs. Diddle, flapping her wing up and down. My wings feel fantastic. She gave the wizard a gold leaf before flying off like the wind. Oh, she might have to get back to her magical fairy tree house to perhaps pick up her kids from fairy tree school, or maybe make magic fairy dinner, or maybe just sit on the couch and eat fairy chocolates. Who knows? Fairy Emma patted over her body. That's fairy better, she said. Her little legs were back to normal. Her nose was no longer like a beak, and her bottom had returned to her backside where it had belonged. Oh my goodness. She fairy flicked her wings a few times to make sure they were working, and then applied some super flick slick flight dust. Have you ever tried my super slick flight dust? It's rather fairy amazing. You sprinkle it on your wings. It's a little like fluffy marshmallow dust, and the most amazing things happen. Do you think you would fly slower, or do you think you would fly fast? I'm listening with my double fairy ears. Yes, you're right. Correct. You would go faster. And then, do you know what she did? She looked very fantastic, except for the 2 little zebra ears sticking out of her head. Oh! I think the spell might not be just okay. Oh, dear. Wizzy does try his best, I know. Let's go to the next page. Page number 46. Fairy Puddle Pops, how can we fix my ears now? She thought of a fairy second. Aha! She pulled out her invisible scarf from her pouch, wrapped it around her ears, and then popped on her flight helmet. That should keep them out of the way, she said. Stardust flicked his mane back and forth. And he was no longer as flat as a rainbow pancake anymore. He had turned them into the most amazing turquoise colour with little specks of golden glitter glistening all over his ears and his horn. You look amazing, said Fairy Emma, jumping on his back. You're not only the fastest unicorn in Starzumbleland, you're the most sparklicious too. Hola, gracias, my peñojada. Vamos to the Sparkle Day Academy. They went. I love when he speaks fairy Spanish because I have no idea what he's talking about. But luckily in this fairy book, when you see things that are bold, can you see where the words, the Spanish words are in there? Vamos. You can go to the back, to the magical fairy dictionary or fairy vocabulary, and you can find what it means, which is pretty cool. Fly like the fairy glitter, Dick, she exclaimed, and they did, waving a fast fairy goodbye to Mr. Wibbly Wombles as they went. Chapter 5. Oh, we're up to the flight exam. Oh my goodness, this is the really magical, special part of the story because we get to find out if she passes her flight exam or gets there on time. I wonder what's going to happen. Let's read it. Fairy Emma arrived at the flying exams in the nick of fairy time. Her tummy jiggled with jelly butterflies as she surveyed the crowds of unicorns, hobgoblins, dragons, flying elephants, fairies, elves, pixies, and tap dancing brownies. What? Duh. They were all waving their glittery wands from the sidelines. Quick, everybody, go and grab your wand. I've got my magical wand. It's my balloon wand. It was given to me by a very special wizard friend called Wibbly Wombles the Wizard. I think you might know him. And this is my birthday wand. I wonder if I wiggle it around and say abracadabra peanut butter sandwiches, will a magical tap dancing bunny appear? Oh, it did. It was me. All right, let's try the next bit. They were all waving their glittery wands from the sidelines of the open air amphitheater. Do you know what an amphitheater is? It's a theater that's outside in the air. It doesn't have a hat or a top on top of it. So everything's out in the fresh fairy air. Cheering on the Tooth Fairy hopefuls, the last fairy finished a perfect triple toast nipple snot somersault, making Fairy Emma feel very, very nervous at this point. She was about to wish with all her heart that Grand Fairy Ma could be there to see her just as Gigglegop found her. Put this on, you're up next, he said, and handed her a glow number to stick on her back. Thankfully, the examiner changed your position from first to last, he chuckled. Oh, that was a good thing to happen. Wowzers. Oh. Thanks, Giggle. You're the best star flight school teacher in the whole of Starzumbleland. She took a deep fairy breath and stepped up towards the cloud platform. Her turn was next. Oh, I've got butterflies thinking about this, even though I know what's going to happen at the end of it. I've still got magical fairy butterflies. Looking over the sky, painted with a kaleidoscope of rainbow colours, she took a fairy moment and remembered flying around Humanland with her grand fairy ma, at first being tucked secretly away in her magic pouch, and then, as she grew older and more confident, being allowed to fly by her side. I do remember that time, being all snuggled up in my grand fairy mum's magical pouch, and we flew out of Starzumbleland and all the way through the rainbow down into human land. It was most fairy amazing. On some adventures, Grand Fairy Ma even let her navigate the flight path throughout human land and back to fairyland above the clouds. So there's her magical flight cloud that she's about to take off for her flight examination. It's a very special one. You've got this in the dragon bag, chuckled Giggle as he flew up beside her and placed a moonstone crystal necklace around her neck and blessed her with the best of dragon luck. She popped on her marshmallow helmet, walked to the edge of the starter cloud that I just showed you before, and took a deep fairy breath. Let's take a big deep fairy breath together. Actually, I think I need to do one more. She popped on her marshmallow helmet. Pop on your helmet. Walked to the edge of the starter cloud and took another deep breath. You've got this, fairy Emma. Magic happens, she whispered to herself. You're going to make a fairy fantastic tooth fairy, said a voice from behind her. Fairy Emma twirled around. Oh, I wonder who was that? And to her magical surprise, there on the most amazing glistening water dragon was her grand fairy Ma. She made it, no way! My fairy stars, I can't fairy believe my eyes, you're here. I thought I would never make it, said fairy grandma. Luckily she did. Next page. Now take another deep breath, little fairy, and show them how you can rock a triple toe, fairy Emma style. Fairy Emma had a grin from one ear to the other. She was fairy pumped and she fairy jumped. As first she wiggled, ooh, bit nervous. Then she wobbled, ooh, and then she regained her focus right and began to swirl and twirl and flip and pivot exactly the way she had practiced. She was getting it right. The butterflies inside her tummy turned into sparks of happy bubbles of excitement. Then all of a sudden the wind flipped and a swift sparkle wind blew in from Snarzleberryland, just as Ruby Dooby, the weather broadcaster, had predicted. Oh my goodness, she's like the best magical weatherologist you would ever meet. Fairy Emma felt her wings being lifted, sending her sideways. Ooh! She clicked her heels twice. Click your heels twice, everybody. Click, click. Which sent her soaring up past the judges. So she went... And with a never seen before triple hipple hop backwards flip. What? That is out of fairy control. Not everybody can do those flips. Oh my fairy goodness. The crowd and the judges went absolutely bananas. Ah, she's done it. Oh my God. Blah, 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 blah. Fairy Emma was doing fab. Then just as she was about to do the last flip of her somersault, she smelt lavender. Oh no, what does that mean? Lavender? Oh my goodness. Oh no, it was the sleepy dust. It must have come in on the Swiss sparkle wind. She pulled out her wand, crossed her wings and chanted a bubble spell to cover her face. Oh, hubble bubble, hubble bubble, hubble bubble, she said. She couldn't believe her fairy luck. The spell worked so well that it covered the whole entire crowd and protected them all from the lavender sleepy dust. In a twinkle, she mustered up all her energy to perform the last triple toe flip of her snipple-snot somersault. Fairy Emma confidently stepped onto the blue polka dot starting cloud and signaled to the judges with two thumbs up. She was ready to start. She slowly swung her left foot up to the sky and took a leap from her right foot whilst flipping into a 360 pike position. Now that ends this chapter. Well, we're still in this chapter, but we will come back to it because I have to tell you something exciting. You know how I went to Princess Jasmine's magical fairy ball the other day? Well, she had found my magic wand called Wandering Wilma, the magic wand. Hello, everybody! Say hi, Wilma. Oh, she has been running all over Humanland Town, and luckily a bubble had snapped her up and taken her to Princess Jasmine's magical fairy palace. So now, oh, she's trying to run away. Whoa! Again. So I've got Wilma, and I'm going to make sure she's... Ah! She's going to go again. Wilma, stay here. You are such a cheeky wand. So let's say goodbye. I'll see you guys soon. Let's go out on some special magic music. And again, happy birthday to all my fairy friends out there in Humanland. See you later when your wings are straighter. Bum, 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 bum. Boogie, boogie, ba, 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 ba. Woo! Boogie, boogie.